you're doing good so far. Welcome to part 3 of creating simple basic kits in Cinema 4D. So Pixel Army, thank you for joining me, and let's go ahead and start. Last time we talked about basic lighting, and I told you guys to experiment and test out the different types of lighting that you guys would want to retest. Now, before we move into texture, let me do something quickly to show you guys a little bit more into lighting. Remember this light that I put in front of the text right here? Let's move it back to 100%, and this time let's move it down the text and right about the bottom, right before it gets all the way to the bottom, like this. Just why I'm showing you this is because I want you guys to show you how to create specular around, like, glowy type edges around the text. So let's copy and paste this, and let's move it up the text. Let's move it a little bit more, almost on the top, but not too much. And let me show you how it looks right here. So basically, with the powerful light coming from the back, it made sense that there would not be such a powerful light going to the front. And I wanted you guys to see the front of the text either way. So with the light on the top and the bottom, you have those edges here, and those edges on the top here still gives you the shadow, still lights up the face of the text, but with not that much power, so you can be able to see that. So just like we did, let's turn those off and turn these back on. Just like we did with this, it gives edges to the text and most likely specular. Okay, so let's move into texture. So what you're gonna do in materials, you're gonna double click and create textures, but let's not do too many of them. Let's just use one for now because we're only using one 3D object. And let's drag this to the outer text, which is basically the text. Let's rename this text, because we're not using inner, so it's just gonna be an outer either way. Okay, so we're gonna be using the first lights that we created, and we're not gonna be using the others. So let's group this and shut it down until we need it. We're gonna be using this. I'm just taking a little time here, double click. Basically shuts it off. Double click, and there you go, just to make things easier. Okay, so let's double click here on the material and let's go through the materials. First, this is the color, which is going to change the color of the text that you're doing. So let's put it red and Command R, and it gives you this, right? And if you put black, Command R, you're not gonna see anything but the low speculars. If you put, basically you get the point. So let's make it gray for now. Luminance, I showed you guys how to do this in the wacky tutorial, so I'm not gonna go over this. Reflection, same thing also, basically the same basic stuff. You click reflection, you select it, and you move down the amount of reflection that you want it to be. So if you had other text around it or other stuff around the text, it would reflect whatever is next to it. So that's the main point of reflection. Environment is, you don't really need environment for text unless it's more advanced stuff. Specular basically gives you that little light glow here. Let's render this to see how it looks like without the specular and with the specular. Specular mostly gives you like the edges of the text and make it more prominent. Okay, so bumps. It's really interesting with the bumps. Let's go ahead and select bumps, and let's put some bumps on the text to show you how it modifies the text. So let's zoom into the text here, and let's go to the bump. Let's select the texture, and let's go to surfaces. And one thing I like to use is rust. You can use planet, but if you can see here, it starts showing some rust on the text. and just some basic CorelDRAW that's rendered to so you can see what it does to the text. It does this. So if you go inside the Rust, you can make it more on the text so it shows like this. And you can modify it along, and basically you'll see what it does. So mess around with that. Also, what you can do with the color, if you want to give the Rust some color, go on texture, same thing, surfaces, Rust. And it's going to give your Rust some colors. And how to change this color, you go inside here. Delete this. Okay, you double click this and you change the color. And you can change whatever you want. Okay, so let's not have the bump. So basically with bumps, you can choose whatever surfaces you'd like, simple noise, galaxy, flame, whatever. Experiment with that. You can load images for bumps, and that's more advanced stuff. But what I like to do is, let's go back to color, select texture, let's load an image. And what I use for standard intros and stuff like that is a texture that I have that's called Grunge 20, which is part of one of the products from Video Copilot. Let's say yes, and it's going to give you that texture and the text. It gives you like a gray metallic texture that I like. And if I go to reflection, I turn on the reflection and let's render. So it gives you this. So I like it pretty much, and that's what I use for my standard intros. Since it's a dark texture, let's put on one more light in front of it. Duplicate the front top light and let's move it to the front. Not too much, and let's move it down. And there you go. That basically gives you the basic intro text that I usually use for my intros. Render, and voila. So that's what I use usually for my intros, and it looks pretty good, and that's what I use for all my intros, unless there's specific demands where they need certain textures, certain more advanced stuff, then I do that. And it that depends on the person's choice. So that's the basics of texturing the text and make it look metallic, make it look like grunge, make it look like earth, and stuff like that. So let's have some more fun with it since we have more time. Double click this, go to the bump, select it, and this, okay, let's just try with the Rust so far. That's what it looked like with Rust. Let's try another one on the surface. Let's try Earth. It's almost like Rust, but it's a little bit different. I don't know how to explain that. Let's try tiles. That's pretty good, but not what I was expecting from it. But there's one that I really like, which is called bricks. Let's try that. So it appears to only have effects on the side. I wanted to have effects on the front, but it only have effects on the side. So here you can see the bumps on the text. Let's get closer and you can see that. So that's what brick does, that's what tiles does and stuff like that. So experiment. Oh, by the way, the reflection that I was telling you about. It shows the reflection of the S right here. So go ahead and experiment with the texture. This is a basic of texture. Play around, do that. As always, like, comment, subscribe. I can't stay too long because I don't want to make those videos too long. Again, send me pictures on Facebook on what you've done, what you've accomplished, and I will show them at another video. But thank you for watching. Like, comment, subscribe, and I'll see you guys in part 4 where I show you guys how to animate and render, and part 5 where I show you guys how to modify in After Effects. Thank you.